Hello everyone, and the YTPC. What all is in this pack? Stay tuned to find out. Well, hello YTPC, and anyone else that's watching. Piping artist Steph here, and I've got my bailout bag. I haven't been doing very many videos lately, but I decided to do this one because this one was right up my alley. So before I begin, I want to go ahead and do a little house cleaning. I was smoking my baby Wellington, but since I'm going to be doing a lot of talking, I'm not going to smoke anymore during the video because I have a lot of stuff to talk about. I busted open just this morning, Taste of Summer. As you can tell, it's about 72 degrees here in North Houston, the Woodlands, Spring, Conroe, Oak Ridge, Shenandoah area. There's a lot of little tiny towns in this area, or not really tiny though. Anyways, I got Taste of Summer. Show everybody. I got Taste of Summer. This was sent to Skip and I from Mel Harris, the garbage man Piper in El Paso. So thank you, Mel. It's a Taste of Summer delicious peaches and cream. It is Sutliff, and man, it's tasty. It tastes like a Virginia. With well, obviously it's an aromatic, and if you guys know me, you follow me, then I'm an aromatic gal, and I've been trying others that aren't aromatic, but I really liked this. It actually didn't have a really sweet flavor, but because today it's 92 to 95% humidity, there was no way to dry it out, so it was kind of difficult smoking it because it was very moist. I got my piping tray that I got from Silent Wisdom Experiment. My baby Wellington. This was a Danny Shore sale by Sue Dunhill purchase, and I just love this pipe. I did just find a crack on it this morning though. Let me show you guys. So there's a little, I don't know if you can see that. Let's let it focus. There's a, yep, there we go. It's a tiny little crack on it, and it wasn't there before, so I don't know how that happened. But anyways, I was using this tamper that LaDon Mott sent us, and I have some bad news. Skip's Christmas gift. Let me show you guys this. I'm super sad. So Skip's Christmas gift. Let's see, come on. It got knocked off the bar, yes, by me, and it broke. And part of the stem is still in the shaft. And I'm very, very sad. So if somebody can leave a comment down below, I really don't want to go with a big company to fix it. I was hoping I could find someone, a member of the YTPC, that does restorations, maybe. Somebody leave a comment in down below and let me know if there's someone that I here in the States that I can send this to and get it fixed for a decent price. And I want to support smaller businesses. That's why I'm saying I don't really want to go with a corporation. I will if I have to. But any of you guys out there that can fix that, get that stem out of the shaft, then fix it. I wasn't going to tell Skip, because I was afraid he'd get upset, but I finally told him, and I told him I'd get it fixed for him too. So that's my house cleaning, and I'll get down to the business of my bailout bag. And I don't do very many VRs these days, and the reason I've got the camera so far back is because I'm gonna start pulling stuff out of it and show everybody what is in my pack. I have, there's a giveaway by 907 Piper, and it's his 100 sub giveaway. I believe he's at like 120 now, but I don't do a lot of the VRs,
because well, we have plenty of pipes and plenty of tobaccos, and I'd rather do trades with paintings and some of my, you know, handmade goods, as well as cigars and tobacco and pipes, as opposed to, you know, winning giveaways. But this one was just spectacular. I believe it was, where would you go for a month? You know, out in the wilderness, and what 10 items would you take with you? Well, my pack had a lot of stuff in it. I went through it yesterday, took it all apart, looked through it, and there's several groupings of items that I consider kits, because if it's a first aid kit, you're not going to count every single individual item in there. If it's a cooking kit, you're not going to count every single spoon, every single dish, or, you know, your little camping stove or whatever you might have. So all of the cooking gear I considered one. So I asked 907 Piper if I could do 10 kits, and he said that that would be okay. So I'm going to go ahead and unload this pack, and I'm not sure if the pack itself counts as one item, but I went ahead and counted it as one item. And then there's also one item that I don't have out or in the bag. There's still room. There's still a lot of room in here for it. Of course, I probably wouldn't take it in the pack. I'd probably take it on my hip. But let me get to it. Unloaded. Let me see if I can't get this camera to be a little bit more straight. I am going to first say that the place I would choose is someplace that I know real well. That would be in the southeastern area of New Mexico. If I was going to go somewhere, it would probably be the mountains around Cloudcroft, New Mexico. I'm going to put a little map up and show you where it's located in southwestern New Mexico. It's beautiful. There's Lincoln National Forest, Silver Lake, Bluff Springs. There's all these beautiful areas, and I grew up camping there as a child, and spent several years living in the small town of Cloudcroft. I'm gonna put some pictures for you guys, and then I know the area really well. And so if I wanted to go somewhere for 30 days, just to do, you know, living off the land and everything, I know a lot of the flora and the fauna out there. There's not a whole lot of fishing. I could do some fishing, but more than anything, I would probably use some netting or something out of all the things that are here to do some fishing. But I wouldn't take a fishing pole and a fishing rod. So I guess let me get into. Oh, I'd also, he asked what time of year. I would probably go mid-September to mid-October because, it would be nice and cool, not too cold, although it is kind of a rainy season at that point. So, not sure if it would be, because August is really hot. September starts cooling down, even in the mountains, but it gets quite a bit of snowfall, so I wouldn't want to do it past November. So, sometime in the fall for 30 days. Now, this is stuff that I had in my pack already. And I had to actually scale down because I had three or four other items. Like I had a gas mask and an extra filter for the gas mask. Both my kids have that too. We have several things that each of us have different, but being a female, my list is a little bit different than what maybe a man would take. Although I'm not sure. I mean, I know one in particular kit, it would be definitely a female kit. Now, I don't have to probably open this and show you guys what's in it. However, being 30 days or any length of time, there would have to be obviously feminine hygiene products, extra undies. And if it was going to be longer than 30 days, old socks. Because if you run out, if there was some kind of actual event where it wasn't a 30-day thing, it was longer, you need something, well, females need something every month. And until I actually am done with that stage in my life, then I would definitely need that. So socks you can rinse out. You can get water and rinse them out. You can dry them on a line. You can reuse them. And I know that some people are like, "Eh, that's gross, don't go there." But that's a necessity for women. So anyone pre-menopausal or... So that's my woman's kit. And then I've got... Of course, my awesome Signal 99, awesome band in Northern New Mexico. I believe everyone in the band is Native. I know one of them is Navajo, and that's my family's tribe. So his wife sewed this for me. So I'm pretty proud of this bag here. But this is my tobacco kit. So I've got a cigar. A tamper. I actually put two tampers in there because this one, this check tool is very useful for several different things. A cigar cutter, which is also useful for several different things. A very light pipe. This is my Medeco. I would throw it in there last minute. But that's my favorite pipe. And of course I've got matches and a lighter and a pack of American Spirits. So the pack of American Spirits and the matches and the lighter always stay in here. And then I've got, of course, some tobacco. So that's my tobacco kit. And this little bag is just absolutely perfect for the kit. So that's that. And then of course I've got my sleeping kit. It's a sleeping bag. And this one in particular, I think, was one that was a 10 to 30 degrees sleeping bag. It wasn't all that expensive. I got it at Walmart or somewhere, I don't even know. And then this is part of my sleeping kit because it's a emergency blanket and a Yukon tarp. So if I needed to drape it over some branches and sleep under it if it was misting, or you know, I needed to sleep on top of it because the ground was too moist, there's that. And of course I could always use a flannel or a jacket, whatever's tied around my waist, as a pillow. So I'm not worried about a pillow, and if you know, if I needed to, I could use this as a pillow if I really needed to. So that's my sleeping kit. So far, that's three. And if we include the backpack, then that's four. And then, of course, I've got a machete. We actually have like six of these, probably two or three around the house. And each of the children and myself have one on our pack. So that's essential. And of course, with it, of course, I've got this all-purpose knife sharpener. So that would be part of my machete kit. Okay, the orange bag. All right, so that's one, two, three, four, including the backpack would be five. This is my water kit. I've got this collapsible water bag. It holds 2 gallons of water. I don't have a filter or anything. I do need to buy iodine tablets because the ones I had got old. They were all old. I had them forever, so I have to buy some new ones. But I do have a Life straw. This actually has a filter inside of the straw. I haven't opened it because I don't want to expose it. Everybody in the house has one. And then we have probably about 15 to 20 of these little emergency water packs. And then of course, my children and I have made homemade water filtration systems where, you know, if you take a water bottle or a cup, a plastic cup, and you know, you put a hole in the bottom of it, you can put some rocks and pack some sand in there and put some charcoal from your campfire in there. And if you have to, you can filter rainwater or filter stream water. I wouldn't suggest filtering stream water if you're anywhere near livestock or farms, or there's an abundance of wildlife, because there might be bacteria that you can't filter out of the water. So unless you're wanting to get, you know, nice case of the runs, I wouldn't use stream water if it's anywhere near an abundance of wildlife or a farm or a ranch that has lots of animals. So that's 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then, oops, I'm gonna have to put this in a new bag. This is my cookware. Oh, I'm missing something. I actually wore my pack all morning doing house chores, so I was sweeping and mopping, did 3 loads of laundry, and did the dishes all wearing my pack just to make sure that I could, and I thought it felt a little light compared to the last time I did that. I don't do that often, but I wanted to see if I was still in shape enough just to carry it around the house and do house chores, and I actually was. It was pretty good, although because of the humidity, even inside the house, when by the time I took it off, I was very sweaty, but that's okay. I got some plastic spoons. These are high temperature plastic spoons. I'm missing, I guess it must be upstairs, I'm not gonna run up and get it, but I have a little tiny iron skillet that this fits in, and I usually keep that with this, but it's not there. So this is toucan heat. So it's 2 cans just in case everything's wet and I need to dry some wood out for a couple of days. At least I have, you know, 2 meals I can heat up with this. So I've got that. We've got 2 emergency rations, and everybody in the house has 2 in their packs. I'm not exactly sure what's in Dunkin's and Skip's bailout bags, because we really haven't talked about what they have. I mean, my kids and I have talked about it, and every few months we'll go through them and replenish them, or if the food's about to expire, then my son likes to eat them. He particularly doesn't care for these kind of rations, but he likes to order or go to military surplus stores and get MREs, and he'll keep those in his bag. And a couple of cans of food and a bag of rice. That's his food stock for in his bailout bag. And anytime we've done a, hey, you know, we've got 15 minutes to get out of the house kind of routine. We've only done it like 3 or 4 times. 15 minutes, let's go. We gotta evacuate. There's a hurricane coming or something's going on. We gotta go. My son will throw extra cans in his backpack, so he would way overdo it with his pack, but if he can carry it, he can carry it. And then I have this little stand here. You can see it's used from times we've gone camping. It's this groovy little stand. So, yeah, it stands up on its own. You can put it on the fire. You can, you know, warm up your coffee. there's a little cup. So there's two things missing from this, from my pack right now. The little skillet, and then there's also a little metal tin cup for heating water for coffee and whatnot. I don't usually take the coffee with me. That's something I would probably grab on the way out of the house if it was an emergency situation, but I would probably throw that in my food bag too. So there's a few things missing from my food bag, my food kit. This is my random necessities kit. The reason I asked if I could do kits, because I don't know how to downscale. I'm a mom, so there's lots of things that I'm like, oh, we have to have that. We have to have that. So before I get to this kit, I'll do my amazing first aid kit, which I find extremely essential. So here we have some insect repellent treatment. So it's for to ward off insects. I've got two of those. Those are military. I've got this little sheet on how to treat stuff. We've got some bug bite stuff and some pain reliever, a little bag that came with the kit of stuff, an extra tiny little first aid kit. I'm always picking up stuff because we do go into this usually stays in the van. And I actually have a bunch of stuff in the stow and go in the van, so I would probably grab some of that if I had to, or leave it in the van if I could actually use the van. I've got a little sewing kit. That's essential for a first aid kit because you don't know if you're going to get a cut. You need to wash it out, and you need to sew someone up, or if you need to sew a patch in your clothing or whatever. And this is some potassium iodide that, you know, clean out wounds. I'm such a hoarder. I probably should have thrown these away a long time ago, but anytime anyone gets any antibiotics, if we don't finish them, I stick them in here, and that's probably not real safe, but you know, you gotta do what you gotta do. And then of course, pain relievers. This is actually a mix of acetaminophen and caffeine pills and allergy pills, so there's a whole bunch of different stuff in here. And then a bunch of bandages, scissors, cream, a comb. What is this little stuff? Cold sore treatment. There's probably some essential oils I should throw in here, but like I said, I went through it yesterday and wanted to make sure that I could scale it down. But yeah, I could probably fit a couple of essential oils in this kit as well. There's still some room. I could probably do three or four little bottles of essential oils, some lemongrass, some tea tree, and maybe some other stuff that you can treat sores with. So there's my first aid kit. And my last essentials kit. This one's gonna take a while. I wanted to make this video under 10 minutes, but it looks like I'm gonna go to about 20, so bear with me. Of course, I've got a flask because girls gotta have whiskey just in case. And of course, if I need alcohol to clean out wounds or something, then that's always good. I don't usually have this many batteries, but double A's and triple A's. I have a little emergency flashlight. Tape. I've got another emergency blanket, two raincoats. I think once they got used, I probably would not be able to fold them up this small again. Inside here, I have a two metal strings that you can use to cut wood with, two whistles, and I have two little razors, folded up razors, so that's a little emergency kit there. Of course, I've got a flint and a striker, so there's my little flint and my little striker. I've got these little tools. I believe I ordered like 10 of them. I gave some out, and Everyone in the house has some, but these are five-star gear. I ordered a bunch of them, and it has can opener, you know, pretty much any kind of thing you need, and it comes in this groovy little case, and I have two of them in there. Okay, being a female, not going to use leaves, so I take toilet paper. There was in my kit, there was a little tiny foldable book on insects, edible and poisonous berries, all which can be edible and which are poisonous, insects, arachnids, flora and fauna that's edible and poisonous. So I would probably throw those in, but they would exceed my 10 items. So, and since I know New Mexico pretty well, and then I've got some glow sticks, two multi-tools, one military grade and one just a cheapy one. You can tell we've used this one quite often. I mean, there's everything in here, pliers, screwdrivers, knives. So, and then last but not least, some rope. This is paracord. And compasses. I mean, I don't know how much we need the compasses, but I wouldn't, if I was going out in the wilderness for 30 days on my own, I would probably even put maybe a little iPad or iPod or something in a charger, just because I really like music. And I'm not gifted as far as playing music. So I saw somebody had taken a little plastic ukulele, so that would be amazing if I knew how to play. But anyways, that's my 10 kits that I would take. Check out 907's giveaway. If there's any questions, leave them in the comments. If my backpack were to not count as a 10th item, I would definitely take a notebook and some pencils and pens and throw them in as well, because I like to sketch and draw and write. So that would probably keep, if I was by myself, I would have to do that to keep myself sane. If I'm not by myself, of course I would hope that what I don't have in my pack, we could supplement in someone else's pack and it would all work out real well. So, working together. So let me see, I think that was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, let's see, I'm missing something. The pack, the ladies' essentials kit, water bag, tobacco bag, machete, sleeping gear, kitchen gear, first aid gear, essentials gear, and if I was going to be gone for more than 30 days, I would definitely take ammo and a handgun, which I would put on my hip. I wouldn't put it in my pack. So I leave it in the locker. I wasn't going to get it out for this video because I wouldn't want to get it out of the locker unless I'm going, actually leaving the house, or I'm going to a shooting range, or it's absolutely a necessity. So, anyways, thank you guys for tuning in. That's my 10 essentials and where I would go and what I would do for 30 days. I would probably trap and do some netting for small fish, small game, and live off the flora and fauna. So thank you guys so much for tuning in. You guys have a good one. Congratulations on your 100 subs, and have a good one.
Hey, girl. Whoa, now. You know you got everybody looking. My big truck, gonna open up the doors and turn it up, gonna stomp my boots in the Georgia mud, gonna watch you make me fall in love, get up on the hood of my daddy's truck.